Professor Dave here. Let's talk about limiting reagents.
He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
When we react two substances, it's essentially impossible to have them present in precisely the correct amounts for both of them to react completely. One of them will be the reagent in excess, and one of them will be the limiting reagent. The limiting reagent is the one that runs out first, which makes reacting further impossible. The other reagent or reagents will then be said to be in excess, because there will be some left over. In order to tell which is the limiting reagent, we have to see which quantity will limit the reaction stoichiometrically, and it won't automatically be the substance that is present in the lesser amount. For example, if we are making bologna sandwiches, we might use the following equation. The balanced equation shows that we need one bologna and two bread to make one sandwich. Let's say we have 7 bologna and 10 bread. How many sandwiches can we make? Well, 7 bologna could potentially make 7 sandwiches, but 10 bread can only make 5 because we need 2 per sandwich. So, even though there's more bread than bologna, it is bread that is the limiting reagent in this example. The bread will react fully and leave an excess of 2 bologna. So, bologna is in excess. Let's look at a real reaction. Urea is produced this way. If we start with 10 grams of each reactant, which one limits the reaction? Well, the first thing we have to do is convert to moles, because mass doesn't tell us anything. We need numbers. So, we convert both to moles using their respective molar masses. We can now look at these numbers a few different ways. One way is to see how many moles of urea each has the potential to produce. Use the stoichiometric ratios to see that CO2 can't produce as much, so that must be the limiting reagent. You could also see how much of the other reactant each could react with. This many moles of ammonia could react with this many moles of CO2, which we don't have. This many moles of CO2 could react with this many moles of ammonia, which we do have. So, CO2 will react completely and limit the reaction. Once we identify the limiting reagent, we just use the data for that substance to calculate how much product we will get, since that substance will get used up. If we used the other one, we would get the wrong answer because not all of the reagent in excess will go towards generating product. Another real-life limitation of chemistry is that the amount of product we calculate that we should get is actually just the theoretical yield. This is the amount of product we can expect if every molecule of reactant converts flawlessly into product. In reality, this does not occur, and the actual yield will always be some fraction of the theoretical yield, which we call the percent yield. Percent yield is actual yield over theoretical yield times 100. So, if you expected 10 grams of product from your stoichiometric calculations, but after doing the experiment only collected 8.4 grams of product, your reaction had an 84% yield. Percent yield is an important measure of the efficiency of a chemical reaction or technique, and is very useful in planning syntheses of organic compounds. Let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials, and as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.